Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about incremental load delete. If you haven't watched last two videos of this video series, so before going forward, I would strongly recommend to watch that video where you can understand about the what is incremental load and why it's required. Then we have discussed about incremental load with insert and update. So today we are dealing with incremental delete. So let's start with incremental delete. So go to on SSMS, and this is our source table and this is our destination table, as we have discussed in our last two videos. So once we will delete anything in our source table and we will run our package, then in our destination table, actually we don't want to delete data from destination table. We just want to update the flag which is deleted in our destination table with true. So how we can achieve this? So go to on SSDT, and this is our package which we have discussed in our last video. So I am going to use that one, and here I would like to use a new data flow task, and this is for delete. So we can connect with our existing data flow task and we can rename this with delete. So this is our delete task. So now double click on this delete task. So inside this data flow task, what our plan? I just want to get data from destination table this time, and we are not getting the data from source table. So once we will get data from destination table, then we will apply lookup with our source table. Like we are having 11, 12 in our destination table, and in our source table we don't have 11 and 12. Like I want to delete these two rows. So data is not available in source table. So once our lookup transformation will work, then in destination table we will get 12 rows, and in our source table we will get only 10 rows. So in no match output we will get 2 rows, which is 11 and 12. Then by using OLADB command transformation, we will update these 2 rows. So go to on SSDT, and here I wish to use source as OLADB source, and we want to use lookup transformation. So I can drag and drop this lookup transformation. After that I need to use OLADB command to update the isDeleted column. Double click on this OLADB source. So here I want to pick data from destination table, so destination connection manager, that is fine. Now click on OK. Then we need to select the table. So here I would like to select our destination table. So we can select, and we can check we have 12 rows, that is fine. Now we can click on OK. Now we need to connect with lookup transformation. I need to configure our lookup transformation. Double click on this lookup transformation. OLADB connection manager, that is fine. And here, as we have discussed, we need to use redirect rows to no match output if any row is not going to match with our lookup table. Go to on connections. So inside this connection we want to check in source table. So we can select our source connection manager, that is fine. So here this is our source table, looks good. Go to on columns, and here I would like to map with employee ID, that is fine. Now click on OK. Then we need to connect this lookup transformation with OLADB command, and here I would like to connect with no match output. If data is not going to match from destination to source, then we want to move in OLADB command. Double click on this OLADB command, connection manager, destination connection, that is fine. So refresh, looks good. Connection properties, here we need to specify our update statement. I would like to update destination table, so that is EMP destination. Then we want to set is deleted is 1, where EMP ID is equals to something. Click on OK. Go to on column mapping. So this is our parameter, and we need to map this with EMP ID, that is fine. Click on OK. So now we have done our package. So once our package will be executed, then we should have 11 and 12 with true in isDeleted column. Now go to on SSDT and execute our package. So package executed successfully. As we can see, from source we are getting 12 rows, After lookup transformation, we are getting only two rows. So two rows, that is 11 and 12. That should be updated. So stop this package and go to on SSMS. And here I would like to refresh this table by pressing Ctrl R. So as you can see, for 11 and 12, we are getting is deleted with true. So I hope you have understand how we can deal with incremental load delete. So if you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.